All right, and one last chance to focus in on one of the privateer riders doing it on his own. Our one to watch is a 63 of Derek Anderson.
Derek was 20th in Moto 1. He's made every Moto this season, and the significance is that Derek is a true privateer. And his race team is made up of his dad, Jimmy, as his mechanic, his girlfriend, Shyla, and his buddy, Jake, helping out with all the work that it takes to go racing week after week.
Three teeth left.
This week was pretty mild. And let me start off by giving any of you travelers out there, don't travel from Vegas to Southern California on a Sunday because traffic sucks. Don't ever do that.
It's Monday, we're here in Cali, SoCal. Just rolled up to the MSR Pro Taper HQ. That's pretty cool. Everything's down here in SoCal. We gotta run some errands today, and this was on the way, so let's go see what these guys are up to.
Hey.
Hey.
What's up, man?
Dude. How are you?
This is the guy that really makes everything happen.
Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's where we've been.
Yeah, I just run some errands today.
Doing
how you doing, man?
Good.
This is the real guy. I guess they're all real guys making it happen. He's the editor for Man vs. Moto right here, standing in front of me. I met him like once before we started
doing
this.
It live, right?
Right. While we're in SoCal, we had a few problems with the bike and just some gasket issues and seal issues here and there. And you know, you can't complain all season when my bike, the motor's a stock. You know, with the help of some Pro Taper chain sprockets and FMF pipe. You know, she held together all season. And you know, you can't expect nothing to go wrong with some bone stock. And so we had a couple of issues. We went to Malcolm Smith, and they've helped me out here and there in the past, and they got me right in, moved me around, and got me dialed in one day.
It's Wednesday. We still haven't rode yet. Back's still a little sore. And so I'm trying to keep up on that Advil and relaxing and doing some hot yoga. Stuff's gnarly.
I spent a lot of time here doing Supercross, you know, on the West Coast, and a buddy of mine, Rob Brown from Race Tech Suspension, you know, he's like, hey, just come here whenever you want, and that's where we went this week.
I don't know if you remember me opening this door, but this is where it all started. Here at Rob's house, Race Tech. Got my bike. They kept it pretty clean in here, it looks like. And then we move over to the rig. Yep, we jammed it in here.
Okay, well, I got to change the sprocket, and you know, you can't really take a big old tire changing stand, you know, with you everywhere. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna wanna go to your local Walmart and find yourself a crate.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, I got a flat tire now. Who cares? I got a tire changing stand ready to go. Privateer Tech Kit. This week was pretty laid back from the weekend prior. I kind of tweaked my back a little bit, my lower back, and you know, I wasn't able to ride. I just kept, you know, barely crawling out of bed every morning. And so this week we only rode Thursday, and we went to Paula, and I love that track.
Ah, pretty sick. We just showed up here to Paula, and other than Milestone, I never thought I'd ride for free in California. And homeboy Kyle over here running the gate is like, hey, don't worry about it. And he's like, been following your show, love it. Freebie today. Paula, I can't wait to ride the vet track. Sickest track here. So fun.
If it wasn't for some of the anonymous donations we received, I don't know if we would have been able to do this summer. We spent, I think, probably over $9,000 in fuel, which actually is pretty good. We've been milking a lot of it. But with the help of sponsors like Motorsport, Victory Circle Graphics, and Dupree One Inc. helping us get that fuel, that helped out big time. But we've already had to reach into our pockets a
a couple times relying on some winnings.
What's up? I'm hoping this thing's in focus right now. Good morning, it's Friday. We're on our way to Lake Elsinore, the final stop of this brutally awesome summer we've had. The reason I'm recording myself right now is I lost my filmer. She left me. No, not in that way. Actually, it's pretty cool. The people we're staying with, saving us a couple bucks, letting us borrow their, red light. Letting us borrow their car. She's on her way to the airport right now to go pick up my parents. So I'm driving this thing, and I would have Jake filming me right now, but he's actually in a race tech motorhome behind us. We're just convoying it on the way to here to the track. But yeah, what's up? It's Friday, I'm filming myself, feeling awesome. Good morning. Last race of the year, can't hold anything back now. Okay, pump. All right, what's up? Good morning. Ready to go have some fun in practice. Getting ready for the first one. Beat practice is out there right now. The guys are looking like they're having a good time, making some good lines, and here you go. Practice went good this week. Final round, we qualified like 24th. You know, that's actually pretty good considering how we started out qualifying this week. The track was crazy at first, but it got better as everything went on. And, yeah, so happy to be here right now. Good. Hell yeah, appreciate it. Have a good one. What do you think of Man vs. Moto?
That, I love it. Great show, man.
Yeah, should we do it again?
Yeah, absolutely. Every year.
Start watching it, guys.
What'd
you think of Man vs. Moto?
It's awesome, dude. Seen every episode. I wait every week to check it out.
Yeah. Can we do it again?
Oh, absolutely.
Come on, man. Appreciate it.
Good luck out there.
I love them.
Yeah?
They're all great. You're doing it.
Yeah, you're doing it. That's what I like to hear. Give me another high five, big one.
Damn, I wanted to go to the pits of me. You know, I was like,
that's why we gotta come out here, man. I know some people don't get pit boundaries. Cool. Have a good one, man.
Good luck, man.
Yeah, that does me too.
How much? How you doing?
Yeah, we're doing good.
Yeah?
Big day?
Could be a big day.
Good afternoon, sir.
How you doing?
How are you? I don't have very much money, but I want to give you some money. And thank you. I watch you every week, you know, and it's just fun.
You have no idea. I mean, even though it's
been a
starting to get hot here in California. Gearing up for the first race. As always, you know what we're going for.
Got you, baby. Oh yeah, Sacramento.
He must be getting excited out there.
We gotta make sure he can see the board. I get a little aggressive with the handle.
Let me tell you, that was tough. First one out of the way, gnarly cottonmouth. There's some good lines though. It's actually track's pretty good. And came out to 20th, got 1 point for the day. So I just gotta go do it one more time. That was it.
All right, one left this summer. Let's end it with a bang, shall we? It's been an awesome summer. We can get emotional afterwards.
Got a good start position this time. Check that out. Result we wanted, but we got points in both motos today, and the season's done now. It's good. you know, my dad, you know, he took care of my bike the whole year. And, you know, like I said, she's just stock, and he's over there sweating gallons, washing the bike, doing his thing. And thank you so much, Pops. And Jake, you know, he came in halfway through the season, but helping me keep the bike clean and, you know, loading up here and there, you know, that helps out a lot. And, you know, my mom, she came to the last race, everyone. And I think one of the biggest shout outs is the girl right behind the camera right now, Shyla. You know, if it wasn't for her, like, you know, she's never done this before. I've already done this for 3 years, and, you know, she doesn't know what it's like to, like, not shower for 4 days, and she stuck it out. You know, we had no idea how things were going to turn out, and thank you so much, bitch.
You know, we didn't know where Man vs. Moto was going to go this summer, since everything was so last minute. Some sponsors were a little uneasy about how things were going to go, but, like, somehow, whatever we did something right, and people were loving what went on. And, you know, I wish we could have got back to, like, all the messages and letters and everything we got. You know, it was like a short, long summer. You know, I've never had, like, a bunch of fans before, so, like, I wish I could take care of each individual one like I had in the past, but now it's like overwhelming. But it's like what I've always wanted, to, like, you know. And, you know, who knows where it's going to go now. You know, maybe Man vs. Moto, like, Europe or Australia, or who knows, like, maybe a supercross deal. But everything's so up in the air right now, but it's something that's in the works, and we're trying to work on something. You know, I mean, to be honest, I don't want it to go again. Like, I want to get that call from, like, Mr. Payton or Mr. DeCoster saying, all right, Derek, you know, you don't have to do that no more. We want you to, like, focus on your results and that sort of thing. But, you know, if we have to do it again, it wouldn't hurt my feelings one bit. We had such an awesome time. We did way more this summer than I feel like a lot of people get experienced in their life. And we got to meet so many great people and have so many fans behind us. It was such a great time. And so if we had to do it again, it would not hurt my feelings. The summer to me was, like, truly Man versus Moto. It was everything we set out to do. And obviously we wouldn't be able to do it without MSR, Victory Circle Graphics, Motorsport.com, Dupree One Inc., and Victory Motorsports. Both MX Hardware gave me a little bonus check at the end of the year. Thank you so much. And, you know, I'd be sitting here for an hour to list all the people underneath to thank, you know. But thank you to everyone, the fans, the views. You know, obviously you guys know, if it wasn't for you, this season wouldn't have been awesome at all. And I want to wish our boys representing the U.S. overseas best of luck, and see you next year.